here's the deal. I believe this to the core, and I know you're going to think I'm a crazy conspiracy theorist, but what the heck. I'm Lisa Michaels. You're watching Red Pill TDS. What they're doing, they when a good person comes, they get elected from their home state. They go to Washington, D.C. They frame them. They do some really horrible things, take pictures, to drug them and take pictures of them with people that... and kids, and it's just not good. So, and then they become part of the cabal. They enrich themselves. All of, you know what? Check out this guy named Kim.com. He pretty much, he's this brilliant, massive man. I think he's in New Zealand or Australia or something like that. Anyway, he helped with the leaking of Podesta's email.
He says he did.
He said with Seth Rich, who was murdered. He was working for the DNC. He was a Bernie supporter. For all you Bernie supporters out there, how can you support, how could you have supported Hillary Clinton when Hillary Clinton stole the primary from Bernie Sanders, took all your hard-earned effort and all your excitement and energy for Bernie Sanders and stole it from him? How in the world did you still want to support Hillary Clinton? It just beside, I just don't get that.
Anyone who lacks the critical facilities,
they need to get rid of, they need to get rid of so many. These people are full on evil.
Anybody who wants to turn the United States into Venezuela obviously isn't thinking very clearly to begin with. So.
Now, what makes you say she wanted to turn?
No,
he wanted to turn it. I know, but God bless these poor millennials and stuff. They're so sweet, and they've got some, you know, I'm the mother of two or three of them.
They're not sweet. They're self-absorbed.
They've been misled by the same schools that are sending people to go out and weaponizing our children against the Second Amendment.
That's true.
So, you know, they don't know. They need to be red-pilled. You need to be red-pilled. Please go out. Seek your own information, too. You go out, you find out your own information, ask questions, keep an open mind, and when you hear something that interests you, go find some more for corroborating evidence on someplace, some other website or YouTube channel or something. But there's plenty of news out there, and if you want to look it up, look up a thing called QAnon. Just look up, I know you're just horrified. But anyway, you know, I could be completely wrong. This whole thing could be completely wrong. So it could all just be a big psyop. But you know what? You decide yourself. Don't let anybody else tell you how to believe, how to come up with your thoughts.
No.
Don't let anybody. That's why we're doing this. Is freedom of speech,
but
right?
You're assuming that people still have the critical facilities to recognize and analyze evidence. I mean, the genius, the diabolical genius of the modern left is to replace critical thinking with individuals with mindless parroting of whatever identity group you're with.
That's right. So, the balkanization of our society.
You know, it's really terrifying for the future where people, you know, don't think for themselves anymore, and it's just, well, you know, you think this because you're so-and-so. Well, what about the merits of what I said? Well, you're so-and-so, so I don't have to listen to anything that you said. And that's what's being essentially taught in the schools now, and it's dressed up in all kinds of fancy academic names, and there's these terrible philosophers, you know, Michel Foucault and Alain Derrida and intersectionality and all of this crap, and it's just a shocking step toward tribalism. Dark ages where it's all about who you are and what tribe
what yourself
you're with.
What you identify as.
Yeah.
That is one of the 9 rules of communist revolution. That was discovered in Dusseldorf, Germany in the year 1919. And that was divide people over controversial matters of no importance. Because they want to divide you, the rich against the poor, the millennials against the, you know, the people who believe in gun control, against the people who believe in the Second Amendment. All of this is just, it's noise to keep you attracted and don't, as you like to say, don't look at the man behind the curtain. They want you distracted. You need to be hungry for the truth. The truth, as they say, will set you free. And I personally believe very, very strongly that it is a spiritual war between, it's been going on since the beginning of time, since God made us. He gave everyone free will. okay? So he doesn't want a whole bunch of people up there in heaven that are like, Gautama, oh, I love you, God, I love you, you know, little puppets. He doesn't. He created us all. He figured it was pretty self-explanatory how perfectly the world is, and all the way down to our minute little cells, it's like its own little city. It's just so brilliantly and elegantly created. It's obvious. There's only one creator. They didn't have a committee and go, okay, I think you should be in charge of making the weather. You should be in charge of the sun. I mean, it's ridiculous. So he allowed us to have choices, and he also allowed the adversary to be here on and in control of this planet too. And we are faced with choices every day. You seek out the truth. You seek out a personal, individual relationship with our creator, and you divine for it yourself. Don't let a church tell you what to do. Don't let the person on TV tell you what to do. Don't let your teacher tell you what to do. Don't let your boss, your spouse, anybody. You need to seek out the truth. That's what you're down here on this planet for, to love everybody, be kind to everybody, and recognize the truth of creation. That's why Trump won. Trump won because people were furious with that. It's exactly
That's right.
And he knows that's his bread and butter. And until this Congress recognizes that he's going to build that wall, and they don't fund it, they don't get rid of chain migration, they don't get rid of the lottery system for migration, he's not going to give them any of this other stuff. They pretend like they want to help DACA. Oh, that was just a talking point. Now that he wants to help DACA, they won't do it because they don't want, they only win re-election with the votes of illegitimate people that are in here in this country and are illegally voting.
That's right.
That's the only reason. And they don't necessarily all vote. They use the identity of them when they register to, or they go get a driver's license or whatever. They use their identity to plug it in, back to your point about the registration rules, to plug it into the registration rolls to vote in their name. And they have no idea.
Well, and these DACA people, many of whom are not on welfare, but many of whom are, and many of whom are not criminals, but many of whom are, you know, we need an immigration system that distinguishes between people who are going to add value and people who are going to subtract value. We have the right to control our borders and let in the people we think will help.
That's right.
And
we
that is
did.
The right that the Democrats eliminated in bill after starting back with the famous traitor Ed Kennedy. And I don't see that likely. I mean, opened up the KGB archives, we found out that Kennedy's buddies were back in there trying to undermine Reagan with the Russians. I mean, people talk about Russian collusion. You know, the things that have happened in the past by the Democrats are just shocking in comparison to the worst of the allegations that are out there now. But
it's not to say that there's not a lot of crooked Republicans too, but it's just what really shocked me since I've come back here. I've been gone since 2013 and moved to Kansas. Is the homeless and problem and the downtown. Do you think there's any correlation with the fact that Portland is a sanctuary city and the homeless issue, not much at all?
Not much.
Do you think it's just because the weather's nicer, it's a better place to like, you're going to be homeless, you might as well be homeless.
The homeless problem is a government-caused problem. And the root of much of the problems that we have is that the Constitution very clearly said that we couldn't have printing press money. They thought about that and they said no, because they had bad experiences with printing press money. And the crooked people on the Supreme Court said, oh, well, printing money, you know, we can do whatever we want. The Constitution doesn't matter. And so now all politics has devolved into getting control of the printing press and making all your friends rich with it. And so the printing press has been running overtime for the last 20 years, driving up housing prices to the moon.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, you have all these idiotic Democratic environmentalist policies, like you can't build any houses. So you can't build any houses.
Oh, and they want density. They drive the price to the moon,
right. And then you wonder why people can't afford houses. It was the government. It was always the government. You know, it's such a sad thing, because then the answer is, oh, no, we need more government to build. You know, we'll have the government take over building houses, and then we can spend $1,000 a square foot, you know, and we can build these palaces at $1 million each for the homeless, and we'll just print up money to do that, and pretty soon everybody will be eating dog food like in Venezuela, because that's what happens when countries go broke. And that's where we're headed if we don't get some control of what's going on.
Well, from my experience, it all reverts back to voter fraud, because if you know that you're going to be reelected in perpetuity because you control the means by which you're elected, as Stalin said, it's not the people who vote, it's the people who count the vote, that count. All of the West Coast is either vote by mail or predominantly vote by mail. and all of the West Coast has been left-wing since that phenomenon occurred around 2000.
Incredible.
And so, you know, being in Kansas now, I'm fully, you know, I'm behind the idea that you guys should just become your own state, your own country, Washington, Oregon, and California, and you can all simmer in your own Venezuelan juices. And
we're Republicans.
So long, farewell, adieu.
We're Republicans.
We are Republicans. I don't really want them to do that. People have got to wake up. Please stop listening to the mainstream media. That is the single biggest, most powerful weapon the left has in the United States right now, is the fact that they control the narrative on their news stations. And thankfully, a lot of people are waking up and realizing, I mean, these people lied to you over the election. They told you it was an utter certainty Hillary Clinton was going to win. You watched the meltdown, the people in tears on CNN and all these other channels on election night when they realized their best laid plans to destroy the world was all going up in smoke, and their precious wicked witch of the West Wing was going down in defeat. You guys, pay attention. They're lying to you. Well, find your own news.
Governments always lie. There's a famous book by an old leftist of that title. I forget what his name is, but it's sad but true. It's so bad now that it's hard to know what the truth is and what isn't, and you have to really drill down into the facts, and then you wind up hitting these brick walls where we don't really know. We don't really know what's going on. We don't know why it is that these trails lead from Seattle office of Perkins Coie, and money flowing to England, and money flowing back to the wife of an FBI agent, and why is she getting a ham radio license out of nowhere, and what exactly, and are they trying
this to... Do you think you'd want to read this if this was a political novel? Do you think you'd want to read this?
It would make a great political novel, and what we have in some sense is the mainstream media sort of trying to spin it in one direction with a political novel, and Fox News going in another direction, and all the bloggers on the internet going in 1,000 different directions, and piece by piece these little facts come out, and it's just... It just gets worse and worse.
Just so you know, because you probably haven't heard this, they got two of the people working on the Mueller investigation were dating each other, even though they were married to somebody else. And they were texting each other, and they said, well, when we were talking about that, one of the texts said that, I know what you mean by our meeting in Andy's office, which was Andrew McCabe, who was just fired. And that they had an insurance policy, you know, like if you die before you're 40. The insurance policy was the Mueller investigation.
There was never a reason to appoint him in the first place other than to harass Trump and keep him under control by the people who actually control the government.
And you've been watching Red Pill, TDS, Trump Derangement Syndrome. Thank you very much for joining us.